Love why I lost because you came back in an episode of Survivalist, The Invisible Strain. Last time, I died again multiple times because of course. Just single ones will be fine. Oh, okay. I understand. This strain is a lot more difficult to fight. So actually, green strain is what I want to fight because my weapons are actually pretty ass. And without actually, so I desperately want to avoid blue strain, red strain, anything that's not green strain, as even fighting them is a bad idea. I'm not gonna pick up any refugees, or I already have a hard enough time surviving on my own.
Oh,
Alright, so they still go down pretty easy. It is getting nighttime. I'm probably going to set up camp near the other survivor group as it's more protected that way. Oh, that's nice. They allow you just to slap down, so I can then slap down this cool kit in there over here. I like how that's like just temporary storage. Okay, my brain turned those two little reeds right there. You see those reeds right there? Into a zombie. I do not know why. Just in case a threat happens, like a horde of zombies out of nowhere, or, you know. Things and stuff bad things happening. So, these guys usually hang out near settlements, so that may be another settlement over there. Sorry about that, something came up. Oh, my character is not completely freaking exhausted. I'm assuming you only can gain constitution through eating good food. I'm assuming demolishing the tent equals me picking it up. If it doesn't, I can go get the bigger tent and haul around a slightly heavier tent. I kind of wish there was a time on the map. Maybe there's an item that gives me the time. The only thing I have really about to go by is, like, the sky and by the temperature. My character's gonna sleep in a little bit because he is severely exhausted. Well, not severely, but you know, exhausted. Even though I'm not fully sleep deprived, I'm going to. That's another thing I did figure out is if you sell a trader a backpack, the trade inventory gets more full. Oh, so they infected chase around animals. I'm gonna use the last cross over here. Whenever spot corpses you do not kill, they are 99% from what I've seen, most likely just baking undead. You also have to watch, because that arrow is, this arrow, the black and white one, I think is north, yeah, north, southwest, east, kind of like direction, I think. This is north behind me. The other arrow is the wind direction, as I'm assuming. Because that is usually used as, like, you know, like on top of roosters and stuff, to help learn the direction of the wind. Another freaking looters group? Are you serious? Let's see if he buys. Oh, I gotta only buy one. Oh, alright, bye! He has a gun. I'm not fucking with him. Thank you. I can ask, let's trade. And he'll tell, oh no, I'm not the trader, the other person points to Carson. Yeah, and he points. Funny thing is, the jerry can's worth more by itself than the gas in the bottle. Oh, you need 766 gold for that, my guy. I don't have a sat phone, but yeah, I'm not giving this up if I ever find one. Kinda like, yeah. I'm gonna find this camp's main trader. Because I have seen infected go after animals, so I'm assuming that that's how they're surviving. I have all this gold for something, for this kind of reason, to buy stuff. But as much as I'd like that helmet, that's probably not going to be a good idea to reduce my sight. Thank you. The savage rattlesnakes have been blackmailing nearby settlements. I wonder if they're gonna actually pay, or are they just gonna murk this one dude? So the rattlesnakes are to the north, or to the west up here. Honestly, it feels like I kind of want to set up all the way back at the start of the map, because it seems like the most safest area. There is a nearby friendly settlement. I'm on kind of the edge of territory. The looters are just continuously everywhere. And I haven't seen any other settlements. Looks like the trade party will go to the... The funny thing is, you almost kind of want to set up near that the zombie zone, because it might cause the guide to demand tribute from you. Get eaten by a zombie. Because it does seem like they interact with the world around them. Check on that trade group. They did seem to run into the bandits. They're hopefully alive. If they're not, I will then loot them for everything they got. If they are, then, well, I'm gonna loot the bandits, because the bandits probably died. Well, the bandit groups are a threat to everything. I'm assuming they would even attack settlements, stupidly. I'm trying to follow the merchants because it seems like they know the safest path. That or they're probably fighting off all the zombies. Oh, they might have had three people and I didn't realize. Or they recruited the guy that just attacked them. This is a funny thing, I could literally become like a camp follower where I just follow someone around. The merchant hasn't moved in a while. I wonder if they got shot. The funny thing is the Golden Boys are the only group that's safe to go really interact with, as the other one is next to a leader's group, so I take the risk of running into a looter encounter. What updates after I move? But yeah, just I'm gonna take the cold damage over being able to see everything, and then, you know, not being able to see. The thing is, I could try to build a camp against the map edge, but I don't know if it's a good idea. I don't know if the hordes of zombies just fall off the side like that or something. Oh, there is a red horde of zombies over there. That might be a poor idea decision to set up my base right now. Although they might just move south and leave me alone, which is the other thing. And if they do attack me, I'm just a single person by myself. I could literally just run towards the settlement, the Golden Boys. A solo undead out here. It is. Oh, it smelled me. I'm guessing the ding is a max aim. Oh, it must be. Oh, no, I can't. Before I do something so reckless. Double save! I didn't grab the water. But I can grab, go grab it later. Thank you. I can always expand the wall later once I, you know, want to. I don't need to do what I was trying to do last time, which is this massive, massive construction. Yeah, that'll actually allow us to see who's out there. is eventually we're going to expand our wall to encompass that mall. Let them wander the camp because nothing's actually here. Assuming they're just gonna, this is new, and then wander off. The funny thing is I could probably use the traders if the traders are coming over to trade with me. As a means of defense. Because the traders are coming over to my community. Well, I haven't found a pickaxe yet. So I will buy it from him. Questions, do I sell one of these toolkits? The other thing is I could pawn all the zombie clothes out to them. I thought I sold my bow for a second, like, wait a minute. I'll go bum some water from this group. Better than going through the possibly zombie-infested way to get to the river. I'm assuming the more and more presence you have, the more and more people try to interact with you. Good and bad. Also hordes. So I want to keep remain as under the radar as possible. Might as well start buying bunches and bunches of seeds for the upcoming spring, like spring planting season. I'm assuming that is then. Now that horde's either going towards the Golden Boys because of how much presence they have, or that horde's coming towards me. Which it doesn't seem like infected really doing anything once they get into your base. They're more looking for people to kill than building, than ruining buildings. I'm assuming if you had farming and other things like that, they would attempt to eat the plants. Is the most thing that resembles food. Clothes is the easiest thing you can easily come by. Ooh, he has food. You know, this video has run a little bit long. Whoops, I didn't mean to eat the seeds, but whatever. Yeah, that'll be it for this episode. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and peace!